I made the best coffee in the world today, and let me tell you, I've never felt better. Hello, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So I put this white sheet up for a photo shoot the other day, and I'm not sure how it looks. It's not like a backdrop, so it doesn't look very clean, but maybe it's a better environment for you? I don't know. But you know what it is? It's sunny out today, so that means another sexy montage at the end. But today's video, I thought I was going to do more of a Kendall Jenner inspired makeup tutorial, but a no makeup makeup tutorial. Does that make sense? I go as natural as possible when I do my self tapes for modeling castings and stuff. I want to draw some freckles on my face, and even though that's not natural, but you get what I'm saying, okay? You get what I mean. Sorry in advance if my eyebrows look whack. Okay, anyway, prepping the skin. I'm gonna use this True Match Lumi Glotion. And I'm gonna... Hello? I thought I heard something. Anywho, I'm gonna spread the Lumi Glotion all over my face, kind of just in the highlighted parts of my face, and spread that out evenly. If this foundation was in the right shade, I would just use this because it's so fucking natural. It's insane. It's the CoverGirl Clean Fresh Skin Milk. I've shown it before in the shade Tan, but it's a little too dark for me right now, so I have to mix it in with a lighter foundation. But if you use this alone, it's super natural. And then for the other one, I'm using the L'Oreal Infallible 24-Hour Fresh Wear. And I'll mix those together, and I'll just put a little less foundation than I usually do with my finger, and then I'll blend it out with my beauty blender. I'm kind of just gonna dot it around my face this time because I really don't want a ton of coverage. I also don't know if I'm gonna do a lip because a no makeup look would not really have any lip liner and stuff, but that's so hard for me to do. I love overlining my lips and having that like plump lip, sweetie. You know what I mean? A really big tip when you're trying to make your foundation look very skin-like is to not apply a lot of foundation on your forehead, if at all. I'm sorry if I sound so weird in this video, like, and if I'm talking so weird, because I have this, it's literally a canker sore on my tongue. It hurts so bad, and I've never had one on my tongue. I'm like freaking out. Now that that's done, we'll go in with the concealer, and I'll probably blend it out with my fingers. I'm using the CoverGirl Clean Fresh Hydrating Concealer. Listen, I'm ready for summer, okay? I cannot deal with this seasonal depression anymore. I can't go on walks because it's frigid. The snow is too much. Just brushing the eyebrows out so they're bushy. Luckily, I am blessed with really thick eyebrows. Okay, I'm gonna blend out the concealer now with my finger. Now I'm gonna go with the Airspun powder and just set under, mostly under my eyes, because I want this look to be very natural, so I don't wanna set too much. Just kinda where you can see where it would crease. I don't think I'm gonna do too much to my eyebrows, just the ends, probably fill them in just a tiny bit. So now I'm gonna go in with just a darker foundation and just bronze my face with that. You can get a cream contour stick, but I'm just like lazy. And we'll just do it this way. It's probably not the best way, but it's fine. It's fine, honey. You do it however you want to. Also, these YouTube videos are just kind of an excuse to get out of bed and move, because otherwise I would be just laying in bed all day. It's just not good for you, you know what I mean? I'm wondering if I should do freckles, because naturally Kendall Jenner has freckles, and maybe I should do that. Now I'm gonna take this Milk Cream blush and put it in the same areas. If this is too much for you also, because I know there's a little more color, but I like that, you can just skip doing the blush and bronzer, or you can just, you know, do a little less than I do. I just think it adds a little oomph, you know what I mean? A little oomph. I fucked up. That one's way too big. Oh me, oh my, I'm the skinniest bitch alive. Okay, so we're done with the base. Now I'm just trying to figure out if I should do lips, because I am gonna do mascara. Not a ton, but I will do it. Am I out of Morphe setting spray? Period. This setting spray, I don't know if it works, but it feels amazing. The mist is so fine. I'm just like not the best at makeup, but who cares, girl? I do this for fun. I feel gorgeous. Listen, I think that looks pretty good. It looks really gorgeous without lips, but it's really hard for me not to do them. Hey, that works. Okay, so now we're gonna do hair. I'm wondering if I should do the sexy montage upstairs with the white sheet or if I should film it down here like I normally do. I wasn't recording that whole time, but so for a hair, oh my God. So for the hairstyle, I was aiming something like this. Very Kendall Jenner inspired. And what I'll usually do is get out of the shower and slick my hair back that way, but sometimes it looks too done up and sometimes I'm just too lazy. So I'll end up brushing it instead. If you have straight hair, you don't have to worry about it because you can just slick it back really easily and then use some like gel or something to keep it in place. And then I have this brush, which will really slick it back when it's pulled up. I'm really having trouble talking because of this canker sore. It hurts so bad. I look it up and I think it's because I literally eat lemons. Like, say I'm eating like, we'll make this dinner sometimes where it's rice, kale, and tofu, and chickpeas, and then I'll take a bite of a lemon. And I think citrusy type things like that can cause canker sores. I didn't know that, and I mean, we have that dish like 2 times a week, so I eat lemons quite a lot. So now that the front is sort of brushed, I'll just keep the back curly because it's fine, it's whatever. Keeping my authenticity right. So I'll kind of just like, this is really hard to explain. I'll put my paddle brush in the middle of my head and kind of brush back like that. And then you can kind of just see what I'm doing, going to the side and going up. I've seen people take 2 pieces in the front and then do it after they put their hair up, but I mean, my hair stays pretty well because it's so thick. I don't really need that. And then same to the other side. And sometimes they don't always look symmetrical, but you know what? I don't care. And you can still kind of see the curls in the back, which is kind of cute. So you can also take a spray bottle and like spray your hair a little bit. Kind of do that sometimes, and then I'll take this brush it while it's up so it gets that really sleek effect. You see the difference? And I think when I do my hair like this, I feel like it looks professionally done, but I don't know, you tell me. I think it looks really cute. And the back doesn't always look the best, but it's fine. And then I'll take this, like, you can do hairspray, but since I don't have hairspray, I just take mousse and kind of just slick it back. I do this a lot in the summertime because let me tell you, curly hair sometimes does not cooperate in the humidity. And although I love my curly hair, sometimes I just have to wear my hair like this so I can sweat peacefully so my hair doesn't look like going through hell and back. So this is the hair. I think it looks pretty good. I wish the part was showing a little bit more, but it's okay. We should be able to pick out the outfit. I think I'm gonna go for like a model off-duty type of look. Okay. Should we do a cool transition? Like, I wonder if I can like just like jump up and it'll appear. I'm really excited to see how that transition went. So this is the outfit. It's super plain and simple. I would just pair this as like some sneakers. I'm too lazy to change into sneakers, but just imagine it.
And I think the makeup went really well.
I think I did a pretty good job. Jeans are from Gap. My top is from Shein.
Gimme. Oh.
Hey, maybe I'll play a little piano. What that song is. Sorry if I seemed a little boring today. I'm in pain because of my canker sore, but
is it hot in here or is it just me? I'm so high in here, been smoking on this weed. Told him go and take a shot on 3. Told him drinks is on me. Yeah, the drinks are on me. I said now go and
I hope hope you enjoyed the video, and please like and subscribe and come back next time. Bye!